Hi, I'm Kirsty Porter and I'm here at UConn Student Union in the Atrium for the charity fashion show in aid of Seed, a charity that helps people with eating disorders. So it's all about to kick off, people are cramming in, there is so much going on tonight. There's fun, fashion, dancing, music, it's all about to happen here in aid of Seed.
And I'm Ellie Lloyd Davis and I'm backstage. Everyone's in there getting their makeup done, the catwalk's being laid out, the jewellery, the bags, everything. I'm going to go and talk to the girls now. So you're here today at the fashion show and helping out. I just wanted to know why you've come today to help out.
Because it's for a great cause. It's for a charity that supports people with eating disorders. So we've got all the models here today of all different sizes. As you can tell, I'm not exactly stickman. What we're doing is we're modelling clothes, bags and jewellery today.
And have you done anything like this before?
I have. I've modelled for the last 2 years. I do quite a bit.
And is it mostly for charity? Or?
I do a lot of charity work. It's probably one catwalk a month, maybe, for charity.
Wow. And is it this first time you've done it for Seed?
It is, yeah.
It is. And are you nervous?
Always. Every time.
You'll be fine and you look lovely and the jewellery looks gorgeous.
On the night, there is a wide selection of jewellery available to buy and were also showcased on the catwalk. Julie Gray, the woman behind the sparkle, told us all about it.
So I'm here with Julie Gray, who's brought all this fabulous jewellery with us today. So did you ask to bring the jewellery?
Well, actually, the girls, Gemma and Amy, saw me last week at an event and they liked what they saw. And obviously, they saw the handbags, the scarves, the pull-along travel luggage. And they said, having this event come along, so that'd be great. So the models are actually wearing it in the show.
Oh, that's brilliant. So do you have any involvement with the charity?
I'm hoping to. Obviously, I learned about the charity and that's why I said I wanted to, because I do a lot for charity anyway. I go to a lot of charity events. I said I'm more than happy to give raffle prizes and everything. So it's all a good cause, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. So you say the models are wearing them. Did they get to pick the jewellery themselves?
They came out on force and chose what they wanted, as in handbags and scarves and jewellery, and they're wearing that tonight, yes.
So do you make the jewellery or do you source it?
I source it from all different places, this country and abroad, and I have everything. There's a whole style and a whole range. One, because you've got to look for the younger people and the older people. Different price ranges as well, but it's all good quality.
Caviar drinking beans, you deserve nothing but all the finer things. Now this whole world has no clue what to do with us. I got enough money in the bank for the two of us. Plus I gotta keep enough letters to support your shoe fetish lifestyle. So rich and famous, Robin Leach will get jealous. $500,000 for the stove, taking trips from here to Rome. So if you ain't got no money, take your broke ass home.
There was something for everyone on the night, including a belly dancer who kept the crowd going with two of her dances, one with a candelabra.
The night was a huge success for the charity Seed, with fashion, dance, jewellery, bags and much more. They raised lots of money and awareness of eating disorders. The night carried on in full swing with a live band.
Be careful what you do.